Good morning, fellow mathematicians. Welcome back to another update video. Before we can get any farther into doing mathematics on this channel yet again, just wanna give you some information on what had actually happened. So with all this hacking, cracking, whatsoever. At the moment, I'm in a live chat with my boys from the channel because Jonas von Essen is trying to break the world record of most digits of pi remembered. And he's at 7,500 digits. You can find the live stream in your subscription box probably if you're subscribed to me. And now about what has happened. So on the, I believe it was the 18th of February, some sponsor sent me a message and he asked if I would like to review their product on my channel. I'm really cautious when it comes to sponsors. Even back then with Skillshare, all of their stuff runs over MakerWatch and it was kind of suspicious and I didn't really take the offer from Skillshare back then because I thought they were fake sponsors. But overall they weren't fake, just so that you know that I'm pretty cautious about stuff like this in normal case. So I checked if their company existed, it was something like traffic agency, I can't remember. I looked if the guy existed, they even had kind of a legit homepage, it looked pretty good. And yeah, I thought, well, I'm going to give it a shot because it all seemed quite legit and well thought out whatsoever. It looked like a real company, so I really didn't think much of it back then. Then I downloaded their file. It was like 700 megabytes big, so it really didn't seem like some kind of virus or whatsoever. Even my security stuff didn't tell me that the website was dangerous or contained malware of any kind. Then I downloaded it, but I really didn't, I really didn't install it on that day. And the next day the guy was pushing yet again if I had already installed it, they didn't receive a download, blah, blah, blah on that day. And I said, I can download it again and install it and whatsoever. He was putting quite the pressure on me, but I really didn't think much of it. It just seemed kind of, he just wanted to get all the things done in the contract. Then I downloaded it yet again. It was a different installer. I don't know, they made some updates to their nice game booster software. what should I say? I clicked on it, I downloaded it, I clicked on it and immediately Windows showed me, well, this is going to contain a Trojan, okay? Some kind of virus whatsoever. And I didn't install it. I only double clicked on it, then Windows showed me that message and I pressed the escape button. But it was already too late. I already had a bad feeling about it, but nothing did happen. Then the next day, suddenly, I looked at my mobile phone. I mean, I was working on my master's thesis and then I don't know, at some point I looked at my phone and I got a whole list of messages. You got locked out from Google Drive, you got locked out from YouTube, etc. And I knew immediately what was going on. This absolute piece of garbage locked me out of everything. And he changed all of my personal information. And the worst thing is I did not have two-factor authorization turned on because I for myself thought that some shit like this could never happen to me. I thought I would be smart enough to not fall for something like this. But well, here we go, even Papa falls for shit like this. And like I said in yesterday's video, you can't really call it hacking, it's more of social engineering. It's just some script kiddie sitting in their basement, taking a look at some YouTube tutorial, getting all the information he needs to write a program like this, like a Trojan. And all it really does is probably, I had my suspicions, is probably replacing service host files. I was looking at my service host file and it had been replaced at this point. It was not by Microsoft anymore. I know of the stuff. Back then I was more computer science interested and I made my own private service, etc. on some online games, whatsoever. So I was more into this kind of stuff and I knew how some of those tricks worked. And yeah, what they basically do is just ping little packages to some IP address packages with your information attached to it. And in my case, it was my Google information. And yeah, this is basically what happened. I'm not ashamed of what happened to me. You can call me a dumb piece of shit in the comments or whatsoever, but it just is what it is. Everyone can fall for something like this. And you should never think of yourself as being smart enough to not fall for something like this. What I have learned from all of this is that I should get myself some YubiKeys, that I should activate two-factor authorization and whatsoever. It's just what it is. It happened, and I'm so glad that all of you tweeted at Team YouTube, etc. That all of you guys, just were there for me, at least the 5,000 people who follow on my second channel. But there's a lot of people following on this other channel, in my opinion. 5,000 people are a lot of people. And if those 5,000 people, or at least a fraction of those, put some pressure on YouTube, then I'm already satisfied with it. And it worked out. Team YouTube was slow, and they really didn't reply to me. you can't really call it communicating with Team YouTube if you ever try to engage with them in a private conversation. But yeah, they did their job. I'm still waiting for my Google AdSense to be part of my new email address and my Google Drive, Google Docs, etc. I'm still waiting for this. If you want to know what happened in between, you can take a look at my second channel, the Trivia channel. Link will be down there in the description, and you can take a look at my old updates, etc. Other than that, if you are interested, I finished my master's thesis in time. 2 weeks for 69 pages. 69! Okay. I have done it. I have done it. And yeah, I'm going to defend my master's thesis on Monday. So in 2 days from now on. And after that, I'm going to give you some information on my master's thesis and what it was about, etc. You can already find it down there in the description. You can download it from ResearchGate for yourself. No worries, it's not malware or anything. Okay, I swear. And yeah, I'm so glad to be back. I thank you guys for all your support. I have my studio now, as you can see. I have some stuff here, and this guy is still at 7,500 digits. Being confirmed to be done. People are already messaging me. Yet again, I can give you a little little room tour if you wish, but just a short one. I would like to give you a more detailed room tour pretty soon. I'm just going to swing you around a little bit and show you what I have here, and after that the video is going to end. Little kiss from the papa. Okay, let me see. Okay, this has been my table and my new chair. And there we have my double blackboards. I bought them from some German provider. And overall, I have some sound absorbers now here at my wall. I hope you can see those. They are pretty amazing. Other than that, I have my wardrobe there. That's all the merchandise I have right now. There are my pervy figurines, and also there you can put your clothes on, okay, to let them dry. And down here we have a boy. Akiro? Yeah, Atta boy. Yeah, other than that, let's put me here. I thank you guys for watching. If you did enjoy this video, please like and subscribe, recommend channel if you like. And yeah, what should I say? I lost a few subscribers, like 500 to 1,000 subscribers, and I thought I might reach the 100k at the end of March, but I don't think it's going to happen at the current rates, because not many people are subscribing to this channel at the moment. The algorithm is not in my favor anymore right now, but I'm going to put out more videos in the next time. Gotta get everything fixed, and after that, I'm back on track. Thank you guys for watching. I'm until the next video. Have a flammable day. Ciao.